Westwood High School in Washington Township, New Jersey. WCTV presents high school football, and I have the pleasure to have Jimmy Avitabile with me today as Larry's in Texas at a party, I think. And, you know, Jimmy, every time I mention your name, my wife said, Jimmy's name over and over. He loves the name, the Italian name. Well, let's talk about tonight's game. This is the quarterfinals. You got the number 2 seed and the number 7 seed. And last year, the number 7 seed went all the way to the final, right?
They were the 8 seed last year, and they went into Ramsey and pulled off the shocker in the first round in the state. They defeated Ramsey. They won their second round game. They got to the final. They lost in the final to Caldwell. But that kind of tells you a lot about this program. They're a 7 seed this year. They're 5-3, but their schedule is very, very good. They've lost to 3 powers in Caldwell, Mountain Lakes, and Madison. So they're coming in here expecting to win and knock off the number 2 seed.
And of course, when you look at Westwood, right now they're getting all their players back. And, you know, they have a fantastic quarterback, great receivers. This is a game, to me, is going to be won in the trenches with both teams. I think Westwood, my feeling with Westwood, they're healthy, you know, and Carsage is a tremendous quarterback. They're getting back one of the young men, the receiver.
Yeah, Kobe Lawton is back. But when you look at Westwood, they excel on defense. They're giving up 3 points a game, which is incredible. They've had 5 shutouts. Offensively, they're scoring over 30 points a game. So, you know, they have earned their numbers 2 seed. And you mentioned Robbie Carsage, their quarterback, outstanding junior quarterback, a running quarterback, a throwing quarterback. Their Dugan, their running back, is excellent. He's averaging over 10 yards a carry. They are a very well-rounded team. But you know what? 8-0, you put that record beside now, and you start off 0-0 now in the playoffs.
Yeah, number Dugan, the young man who kicks, he started kicking for the first time. Oh, my goodness. We were just hit by a football. But Dugan, this young man, as a kicker, he's phenomenal. Not looking any place to go to in college. He wants to go to Notre Dame to school.
Yeah, no, listen, not only is he an outstanding running back, you mentioned the kicking game. In years past, Westwood hasn't necessarily been strong in the kicking game. The fans will notice tonight when he kicks off, he puts the ball in the end zone, which allows that defense to really pin that offense down. And, you know, he also kicks very accurate and extra points, which is an advantage come playoff time.
Well, you know what? We're ready to play the game, and right now we want to go. Let's meet the Cardinals, and we'll go from there.
Yanni Constantinides, senior linebacker.
AJ Milo, senior running back.
Kobe Lawton, senior wide receiver.
Anthony Sabatello, senior running back.
Jack Mactis, senior linebacker.
Jack Dugan, senior tight end.
Dance Rose, senior safety.
Chris Pickenick, senior left tackle.
Kirk Schmidides, senior lineman.
Andre Petracchi, senior cornerback.
Ethan Carroll, senior defensive end.
Justin Singer, senior defensive end. Aiden Carazana, junior DB.
RJ Usher, junior nose guard.
Joey Klein, junior wide receiver.
Joe Morrow, junior guard.
Mike Carsage, junior linebacker.
AJ Battelli, junior tackle.
Thomas Busnic, junior wide receiver.
David Gabordi, junior tight end.
Braden Roberts, junior right tackle.
Luke Biello, sophomore linebacker.
Tyler Roberts, junior right tackle.
Sean Morrison, sophomore safety.
Abby Carsage, junior, quarterback.
Aiden Dugan, sophomore, running back. Dante Downey, sophomore, right guard.
Luke Busenich, sophomore, wide receiver.
Jake Sembler, sophomore, wide receiver.
Nick Trippi, sophomore, safety.
Connor Stewart, sophomore, cornerback.
Eli Tavares, sophomore, running back.
Dylan McKinnon, sophomore, outside linebacker.
Jordan Yepes, sophomore, H-back.
David Ismoli, sophomore, wide receiver.
Travis Mayak, sophomore, guard.
Cooper Smith, sophomore, tackle.
Zion Ridley, sophomore, tackle.
Cypher Planker, sophomore, kicker.
Steve Klein, freshman, safety.
Officials assigned to this game are members of the New Jersey Football Officials Association. The rules governing this game are the National Federation High School Football Rules as adopted by the New Jersey Interscholastic Athletic Association. These rules differ from those used in collegiate and professional football. The referee tonight is Richie Aponte, umpire Terry Shubridge, head linesman Robert Cabinas, line judge John Ramsey, field judge Vinny O'Reilly. Side judge is Mark Mundy. The clock operator is Nick Urbanovich. John Mead, Dennis Mead, and James Bennett are your chain crew. The scoreboard clock is official. Ladies and gentlemen, we ask that everyone please stand for the national anthem performed by the Westwood High School Marching Band.
Here we are with the opening of Westwood game against Hanover Park Hornets. This should be a great game, Jimmy, you know?
Yeah, and two very good teams, as we mentioned in the opener before. You know, Westwood undefeated, 8-0, tremendous defense, 3.5 points a game. But yeah, both teams start 0-0.
Well, you know, it's what you want. You know, some of the returning guys from Westwood are going to help out. Number two, we got to mention that young man for Westwood, Kobe Lawton. That young man is 100%, which he was a little banged up. And, of course, everybody else is ready to play. And, you know, Carsage is ready. You're going to go 44, Jack Dugan, the young man. Unbelievable player.
They have a lot of weapons offensively, Westwood, and that's why they're averaging 37 points a game. You mentioned the health. This is probably the healthiest they've been since preseason, so they're getting healthy at the right time. And, you know, we shall see. But Hanover Park is a 5-3 team. But look at the three losses. Caldwell, which has won 24 games in a row. They lost 16-14 to a very good Madison team. And they've also lost 14-7 to Mountain Lake. So, you know, their schedule is good. It's a good team. Should be a great game. And I'm just happy to be here with you calling it.
Oh, it's tremendous. You know, what a great day. Perfect day to play football today. And, you know, we'll be able to with the numbers, especially with the Hornets, we'll be able to see that on the TV. So we'll be able to let them know that the numbers, because they're going to have a tough time with the white on white.
Yeah, it's tough. As you mentioned, John, the coin toss, Hanover Park won the toss. They deferred to the second half, and Westwood's offense will be on up
well,
deck
we'll
first.
We'll see what the number one quarterback. He's got to be one of the number one quarterback, at least in Bergen County right now.
Yeah, as far as dual threat, the ability to run it and to throw it, you know, we saw him go out there and throw the ball against Ramsey and have a big day. And he certainly is the engine that gets that train going for Westwood.
I can't wait till we get started here. We're in the first quarter, you know, beautiful night for playing football.
For
those numbers are beautiful.
Yeah, we can see them now.
We can see them perfect.
Their kicker kicking off for Hanover Park will be number 14, the junior, Ryan Roberts, a very good kicker. Two very good kickers tonight, which is a pleasure to watch. You mentioned Dugan for Westwood, a tremendous kicker. So, you know, take a look at both kickers.
You know, if I compared all the kickers, Dugan is the only one that's 100% through the end zone. You know, so come on, into the end zone. He went to Bergen. Here we go with the game. That's number 9, Joe Klein.
You know, that's a tremendous, that's a 40-yard return, which really sets the tone, gives their offense great field position on their own 45 to start the first drive.
Unbelievable, right? Good start in the game. Look at it. Uncle Matt clapping for Westwood.
John, there he is.
He must have heard us. All right, so let's see what happened on the first play from scrimmage.
Hanover Park likes to run that 3-3 defense. You see that 3-3 stack? Their linebackers are sophomores. They're
so
they make
three,
a lot of tackles.
Five,
yeah.
Or 3-4-3.
Yeah.
And they go to Dugan. 10 yards.
I tell you what, he came in, picked up 11 yards. He's only averaging over 10 yards a carry. So far, he's got his average. And, you know, if Westwood can run the football consistently, they're going to have a lot of success tonight.
In come Carson. Yeah, you know what it was? It was perfect. Blockers were in front. We're going to give the ball to the fullback, and we'll see how many yards we can get on first play.
Yeah.
And they got 10 plus. Nice fake. He's going to have to.
And a pickup of about 3 yards. That's the one thing he does, John. He can make something out of nothing. They ran a little bootleg there. He got out on a perimeter. They covered the receivers and not to make a mistake.
And he said, let me see what I can get. 3 yards is better than getting knocked behind the line of scrimmage.
Yeah, or throwing an interception. So that's, you know, that's an experienced quarterback. It's a second-year starter as a junior. So he really controls that offense for him, for Westwood.
Nice shot, number 44, Dugan. Then he's got a younger brother that comes in, too.
Yep.
Well, you know, it's a quiet part of the game. Uh-oh.
Yeah, looks like we got against
Westwood.
Full start, five yards. That'll back him up. That'll put him at about second and 12, you know.
I know that referee.
Yeah, he's the former, softball coach at Teaneck, Richard Ponte.
That's correct. Very good. I would have had a little tough time getting his name, but I remember the face.
Yep.
He's got the white hat up there, right? So he's the head referee.
Yes, he is. Got a second and 13 here for Westwood. Picks up about four for Dugan. That'll set up a third and nine.
Number 60 on the stop. It looks like, well, I don't have a six. Let me get.
Now, that's the one thing, John, you have. We do our homework. We get a roster, and they change a number on you.
You're right. Well, I had a 61 and a 58. And I was using, this is the up-to-date schedule.
We got a big third down.
So that's our first mistake.
Big third down and nine for Westwood.
A little pass, let's see. Number 24 on the stop. Nick DeVino.
Yeah, Nick DeVino is there. He plays linebacker, but he also plays some nose guard for them. Very quick and athletic. You saw that on a play, and you know it's going to force Westwood to punt.
Great job by 24. So here's number 44. Punting. He also punts to about the 15-yard line.
And not only was that a great punt, John, but great coverage and 32 for Westwood.
Dugan.
Aiden Dugan.
It's a young brother.
The younger brother.
So one punts it, and the other one makes the tackle.
Yep. There he is on the sideline getting the celebration from the rest of the team.
Well, now we'll see what the Hornets will be doing.
They like to run a spread gun offense. Their quarterback number 18 is Mike Borrello.
All right.
Their running back most of the time is number 6, Spinelli.
He's more of a running quarterback than a passing quarterback.
And there he is. First down, they run him. It picks up about a yard, and that, you know, that's the thing about Westwood this year, their ability to stop the run. And
that was Dario Maturin.
Yeah, the sophomore, outstanding sophomore defensive end.
And that's Bucinich, number 11. You feel it, you're right in the backfield, you know. A pass down here, great throw. That was number 88. Number 88, Kevin Loparnos on the reception.
Yeah, great throw that time, and you know, big first down for Hanover Park. Picked up about 30 yards on that play.
Nice size for Loparnos.
Rolls out, trying to take the out pass to Smith, number 11.
9-yard gain.
Yeah.
Looks like number 7, Carrizana on the stop. With Bucinich. Well, the first couple of plays, you can see that the Hornets are ready to play.
No doubt.
Which we expected. So Madera made the reception and a first down.
Yeah, they ran a little counter boot that time. They faked the counter, booted the quarterback, hit him out in the flat. First down on the 44-yard line of Westwood.
Quick play. They took about 4 seconds.
Looks like an offsides on the nose guard for Westwood.
I'll
tell you what, John. They do not have to give Hanover Park any help tonight. Park can move the ball. Gave him a quick 5 yards. Now we got a first and five on the 39.
Now you have several plays you could run. Look at this. Trips to the left. Hand off inside.
He gained a few.
It looks like
Mike Borrello, the quarterback.
Borrello on the carry.
Hey, he's a big quarterback. He's 205 pounds. It's like having an extra fullback in the backfield. It'll be a second and about two for Hanover Park.
Inside handoff. Looks like a first down.
Yeah, that time.
That's number one, Melia.
That time they were in their pistol formation where they put Emilia at tailback. They moved Frankie Spinelli to fullback.
I was watching the one Loparno's pick up Emilia. He said, get up, young man. Come in, let's go back and get the play. Here we go, quick play. Trips to the left. Gain of a couple.
You know, they like to spread the ball out, not only to throw it, John, but they like to get people out of the box, and they like to use that spread formation to run the football, as we're seeing on his first drive.
Spinelli ran about 3 yards. Yep. Nice crowd there. Cheerleaders, look at that, hey?
Here they are in that pistol formation again.
You can do a lot of things with that setup. This number one down to about the 16-yard line.
Yeah, that time they ran a stretch, an outside zone play, and Amelia was able to get to the edge. Good blocking, and they got the ball on the, looks like about the 18-yard line, first and 10.
And look how quickly they come right back. 18 with the ball.
Yeah, great job that time.
Loss of a couple.
Yep. Number 11 on the tackle for Westwood, Tom Busanich.
He's a player.
Bring up a second and about 12. They lost two on that play. And look for Westwood to start being a little bit more aggressive on defense. We don't even need the officials to make the call. We have our.
That was from the stands.
We have it's the stands. We have the extra officials in the stands making it a legal.
Well, you reacted.
Yeah, be a legal motion penalty. That'll back them up five more. That'll put them on a 25. Now you'll have second and 17.
That was beautiful. That was a classic. And after eight finished them off, that was Yanni Constantinides.
Yeah, they ran Frank Spinelli in the flat that time. Westwood was in his zone coverage and did a nice job there. We sets up a third down and 17.
One by Joe Klein with some help from Yanni Constantinides.
Oh, man, Yanni Constantinides on it with a little help there. It's a big play here for Westwood defensively.
Absolutely.
And Hanover Park offensively. Great job that time.
Number six that time. Dario Maturin.
Sophomore, the super sophomore Dario got his hand up blocking. That'll bring up a fourth and 16. We might get a field goal here attempt.
That's a good That's oh.
By Ryan Roberts.
I don't know what's happening. They must have. Well, no, it's.
So it looks like it'll be a 40-yard attempt 40 here. From the left hash.
A soccer-style kicker. Oh, my goodness. He can make that from. No good.
Yeah, I'll tell you what. Certainly had the distance there, but just wide left.
And he can make it from the 50-yard line.
We've heard a lot of good things about him. Obviously, we know about Westwood's kicker, but just short to the left, and that was a big series for Westwood to get off the field with no points. And we 7 minutes in here, 5:08 left in the first quarter, we still have no score.
Well, a little mojo was slowed down at that point. It looked like that the Hornets were going to go all the way in to score that time.
Yeah. Hey, listen, we talked about it all week. They're here to play, and we knew this was going to be a tough game.
Oh, absolutely. And this is big. Obviously, if you lose here, you go home. That's right.
That is Dugan. Dugan again.
Look at this guy. Look at the raise. I got a hug. That's what. Touchdown. What was it? 24-yard line, 76 yards.
You know, that's the one thing we saw about Dugan in the Ramsey game. Not only is he a tough runner, but his speed is surprising. When he gets out in the open, John, he's very tough to catch. Talk about a momentum changer. You get off the field defensively. Next play, you go 76 yards.
We're going to have to use a pencil. I think the ink, that run was so good, it blew the ink out. But you notice the speed of that young man. And here's a young man that's got it all. He can kick, he can run, and he goes 76 yards.
And now we'll
and
see
now he's got to kick
now
an extra
point.
Now
he's got to kick. We'll try to see the extra point here. Yes, yeah, and we have looks like we'll have a running into the kicker penalty on Hanover Park, which will move the ball up 5 yards on the kickoff. But
he doesn't need that 5 yards. No,
that's just what you wanted if you were Westwood there, to get that quick lead, get that early lead, and settle yourself down. And with 4:53 left in the first quarter, Westwood's up 7-0.
And old mojo was strictly the Hornets until the Westwood took the ball, and you notice the speed of that young man.
You know, we were at the game against, you guys did the game, you and Larry did the game against Ramsey, and he broke that first play of the second half for 80 yards, and I turned to someone on the sideline and said, wow, I didn't realize he was as fast as he is, but he certainly could run.
Oh, they couldn't catch him.
No. And here we go, you're moving up to 5 yards. And the one thing about him kicking off, John, is most of the time it's in the end zone. Now we give him an extra 5 yards. And
that's maybe the little breeze.
Yeah, that's a tremendous advantage at the high school level. If you can have a kicker kick the ball in the end zone and force them to go 80 yards and not have to worry about giving up a kickoff return.
I think he's got, for the last whatever kickoffs, they've all been in the end zone. That's quite a, let me see what he does. Look at this. Open, that was open to a crossbar.
That was about 9 yards deep. And that's a great thing for Westwood. Now their defense, you know, you got to force Hanover Park to go 80. And, you know, that momentum is in Westwood's favor right now. There's the Westwood crowd. They're excited. You can see them. But, it's about 50 degrees outside, no wind, and you could tell it's football weather right now.
We can probably go to my T-shirt.
No, I don't know about that.
Well, you know, I'm being my age. Yeah. You know, I can do anything. Nobody bothers me.
Here we go for Hanover Park. They're in an empty formation, 5 receivers, quarterback run, and he looks to pick up about 4 or 5 yards.
Number 6 on the stop, Dario Maturin, as one of them. But the Hornets quick with the plays. They want to run more plays. Mm-hmm. number one.
It's a great job at the corner there.
That looks like number seven, Carrizana.
That's a great job of getting to the line of scrimmage. Here we go, we got a quick third and three for Hanover.
Looks like trips.
Trips
looks
to
like
the
trips
left.
To the left.
They do have a big receiver in number 11. He's a 6'5 target. They're running quarterback power. He looks to be short.
55 on the stop. Joe Morrow.
Yeah, let's see if they go for it. They're going to have a fourth and one. It's a key early decision. They're going for it, it looks like.
There's no tomorrow.
Let's see if they try to draw Westwood off sides. He's got it.
I think he got it. Looks like 72 on the stop. R.J. Usher.
Yeah, we mentioned him as a running quarterback, like a fullback. He's probably had six or seven carries already.
I like where they take very little time to get
pace,
a play
yeah,
in. You know, this way
really
they
good.
Double the plays. And you tie your other team. Oh!
We got a pick.
Joe Klein.
Yeah, let's see the call. There's a flag.
I think maybe a hit. Let's see. Let's wait.
An eligible man downfield for Hanover Park. Was there an interception?
What? They should get an interception, right? Yeah.
If they ruled them in
bounds. That's correct.
No, they're ruling an incomplete. They're ruling an incomplete pass, not an interception.
Okay.
Westwood declines the penalty. They'll bring up a second and 10 for the Hornets.
Westwood declined the penalty.
Must not have got his feet in bounds there. I thought
that's
he did.
That's correct. Yeah, it looked good. Did a nice job.
Matt Melia with the run there. They're running back, slot back. And again, great job by the defense. Containing him, forcing him to the sideline.
With that Maturin, number six.
Yeah.
He covers a lot of ground.
And the corner again, number seven. Aiden Carrizana. Here we go, third and 10 here. And for Westwood, you're looking to get off the field again.
Trips to the left.
That's a lateral. That's a lateral. Oh, he's calling it incomplete.
Well, they're checking it out here. Well, let's see.
He's very, very close to a lateral. But again, our man, Dario, number six, right in on the quarterback.
They got nice wheels for the defense.
Yeah.
There is a flag.
Might have been a grounding call on their quarterback.
It could be.
They can decline it and take the fourth down and just what you wanted. Yeah, intentional grounding. Loss of down. It'll be fourth down.
All right.
And Westwood should get the ball in pretty good field position here.
You notice the momentum has changed.
Yeah.
When it first started, we felt that the Hornets could do anything.
They did take the penalty because it is a loss of down. They took the penalty, back them up to about the 21-yard line.
Obviously, got to be a punt.
Yep.
And we got to pick up who's deep for Westwood. Well, we're going to wait.
And that's a short punt. And fielded on the 47-yard line.
By number nine, Joe Klein.
Our buddy, Mr. Joe Klein, who returned the kickoff, the opening kickoff. And you know what? This is just what you want if you're Westwood. You got a two defensive stops in a row. You got the ball coming out on the Hanover Park 47-yard line. Let's see if they can keep the momentum.
First and 10 for the Cardinals at the Hornet 48-yard line.
They made some adjustment, Westwood. Beginning, it looked like the Hornets were going to just take the ball wherever they wanted to go. But Nice fake by Corsage.
Look at this kid.
Look at that.
He finds holes. That's a big 6-yard gain on first down. And when they get him running the ball, it makes everything else open up.
I tell you what, I could take him someplace and teach him to slop.
That's, remember that?
Oh, this young man can dance. he's got a nice little pass.
We got a pitch and catch out there.
Number two,
our boy Colby Lawton again.
He came back. He was hurt. Yep. And now he's there. But you notice how the momentum changed.
And you notice now that Westwood's starting to speed up their offense. They're starting to run some tempo.
I think right in the beginning, for whatever reason, they were a little bit flat.
On their heels a little bit?
Yeah.
But first and 10 for Westwood on the 35-yard line. 7-0 with 2 minutes left in the first quarter.
There he goes.
Great
that
job.
That was great defense by number 6.
That's
Spinelli. Oh, nice little Italian.
Yeah, Spinelli who's also their running back. Great job on the perimeter. He'll bring up a 2nd and 10.
And to bring number 44, my man Jack Dugan, is important. Well, you know what? We're still in the first quarter. Beautiful day to play, though. Go back in your days when you were coaching. Did you like these days or when you played?
I did because there was no wind. So. there's an RP.
And it was a forward pass.
Yeah, that's a little RPO, run pass option. Corsage to Dugan. I think he tried to turn up before he caught the ball.
That's right.
But it'll bring, there's our quarterback, Robbie Corsage. And
a junior.
Junior, 3rd down and 9 for Westwood. It's probably 2-down territory from here, John.
If you're rooting for Westwood, you'd like to see them get 7 points from here.
You know,
just to build and get 14-point bulge.
Yeah, we're running a little empty. 5 receiver
trips,
set.
Trips to the right.
Empty.
And 2 to the other side.
This is the one thing about him. he can take off at any moment.
Picked up about
9 yards. It's going to be close.
Close to a first.
You know, that's the dangerous thing in this offense, the spread offense, when you have a quarterback like Robbie who can run. They give him a first down. When you spread people out and they spread their defense, that gives him a lot of space to run.
And he doesn't show you the speed. He picks up speed. He fantastic young man. And only a junior.
Yeah, very, very calm as a quarterback.
Oh, that's
the Cardinal.
The angry Cardinal. Look at that. That's a mean Cardinal. I'd be afraid if I got caught in the dark with that Cardinal. There goes
Dugan again. They ran Dugan that time out of the Wildcat. They ran the sweep.
You had Borello and a couple other young men to stop him.
As we spoke before the game, their linebackers are their strength. They're very athletic. They're very young. They're all 3 of them are sophomores.
And they'll put 3, 4, 5 linebackers.
Yeah,
right, the way
they really run to the football. There's Coach Guy, I believe, the offensive coordinator. Or it's tough to see, I think. Maybe not.
Or it could be the line coach.
Yeah, Coach Amelia.
Amelia. He was the 2000 year. Nice shot, though, 44.
That should be the last play of the quarter. They picked up about 7 or 8 on a sweep, and that time their safety came down to make the tackle.
So we just have 7-0 in the first quarter, and that was Dugan with the 76-yard run.
We come to the end of the first quarter.
But this is a game that you got to score a couple more points, a couple more touchdowns.
They have them on their heel right now, John, and I'll tell you what, when this offense gets going, it's tough. They have so many different combinations that they can play, so many sets, so many different people that can hurt you.
The cheerleaders.
Westwood cheerleaders.
Yeah, they're just chatting right now. They're not cheering.
They're waiting for another touchdown.
Absolutely. Look at this.
Snack stand. The Pat, tell you what, the parental support in Westwood, as far as their touchdown club, is incredible. They really, really do an unbelievable job.
The Minas family, the Porgy family,
a young Cardinal fan.
We got to find out who that is. But look at the way he's staring at him.
Yeah,
he says, stop talking. I want some candy.
Maybe in about 15 years, he'll be out here on a Friday.
Look at what a cutie.
Yeah. All right.
We don't want to look at the ambulance corps. Not on my birthday. You're right. I'm behaving, by the way.
All right. Third and two for Westwood. Quarterback counter to Dugan, and he hits the seam there. He's inside the five. He's down at about the 1 yard line. That time they had him at the Wildcat quarterback again. They ran a counter, and now, you know, the offensive line is doing a great job.
And you notice he was slow moving through that.
He really set up the blocks that time.
So now they're on a 1 yard line.
1 yard line.
Oh, look at that. Gee, what a cutie. Hi, how are you? Look at him. He's probably going to smile. He's smiling right through TV.
He's saying, Mom.
Look at this. Mommy, that guy's smiling at me.
He's saying, Mom, I want to watch the football
look at
game.
That.
All right. Here we go.
All right, back to the game.
First and goal on, it looks like, the 1 yard line for Westwood. And here we go. Dugan again off the right side, and he's in.
Off the right side.
1 yard run.
Dugan. Yeah, Cardinals are up 13-0, but let's talk about where this starts. A kickoff through the end zone pins them deep on the 20-yard line, a three and out, and a punt to midfield, giving you a 50-yard field.
Short field.
Yeah, instead of an 80-yard field. That's the advantage of having Mr. Dugan as your kicker.
And now he kicks an extra point, let's see. This young man doesn't leave the field.
I wonder if he brings the pylons and the down markers in after the game.
It's taking a long time.
Yeah, good snap, good hold, and it's blocked.
Oh!
That's the point, blocked by the Hornets.
All right.
With 11:13 left in the second quarter, it's 13-0.
But that extra point that was missed, though, or blocked,
yeah,
could get.
You hope it doesn't cost you later on.
All right. Okay. Yes.
I think the cheerleaders are
I think.
There they are.
I think they're planning what's going to happen tonight.
Coach has got him in a huddle. She's talking to him. She's calling the play. So you're in there with the hat on?
Yeah. Look.
There's the angry Cardinal.
Angry Cardinal. He's looking. I'm going out tonight dressed like this tonight.
Look at him.
Look at those teeth on him. My God.
He's menacing.
Those are choppers.
Yep. Ready for the kickoff.
Hey, listen, it's 80th birthday. I can say those things. let's go back.
Jeff Dugan set the kickoff again here. Another deep kickoff again in the end zone.
I gave him the nickname the toe. He always kicks it through. So it's 70, 75 yards.
It's funny. I know you were talking to his mom earlier today that this is the first year he's ever kicked.
You know what he did? He went to Bergen, and somebody gave him some instruction, and then he started kicking.
That's unbelievable.
Never before. And the young man kicks in the end zone all the time.
I remember the years when Westwood won the back-to-back titles with Coach Campanelli. He used to squib kick. You remember?
Yes,
he used to
yes.
give him the ball on the 40-yard line. First and 10 for Hanover Park on the 20.
And this puts, you know, 80 yards
yep.
that they have to go.
Okay.
Number 3 on the reception. Madera.
Dominic Madera from number 18. Mike Borello rolled him out right, but that's, you know, if you're Westwood, you'll give up a 3-yard play
Absolutely.
In the flat.
2-yard gain. That'll bring up second and eight.
Bring up not second and seven. Yeah, that time they motioned the back out into the flat and ran like a quarterback draw.
And that was Constantinides
on
the stop.
Third down and about six for Westwood again, if looking to get off the field. We got a third and six here. Looks like Westwood has gone to their nickel package or their dime package here. Trying to get people out in the yeah, flat.
Absolutely.
Oh, bad snap, fumble. Looks like it's picked up by Westwood. Number 34, Dave Gabordi. 34 for Westwood.
Gabordi.
Yeah, again. The defense of Westwood gives the offense the ball right on the 22-yard line. How'd you like to have this field position every time? Okay. And, you know, Westwood here, they're up 13-0. Might be looking to deliver an early knockout right now.
Oh, sure. A big turnover.
You know, we mentioned that Hanover Park last year with their upset and their belief that they can get it done here tonight. If you can get this ball in the end zone, that might put some big time doubt
well,
in their heads.
That'd be 20-0.
Yep.
Oh, 20. So, you know.
What was that? You know, that time he makes something. It looked like there was a bad formation. That time he picks up about 15 yards on a busted play.
But you notice how he waited for his blocking and came inside.
That's the crowd, Westwood crowd, happy crowd.
They're on the 7-yard line.
Yeah.
Looks like the seven.
Yes.
But that's what a nice runner is. He waited for his blocking. He must run a couple of miles every coming out
and
getting the plays from the offensive coordinator.
Now this time they've got Dugan back in a Wildcat. Yep, they ran that. They faked the ball to Robbie Karsich that time, and they ran a sweep to the short side. He picked up about 3 or 4 yards. That'll give him second and goal on the 4-yard line.
4-yard. Another play showing, you know, pick who you're going to go after.
Yeah, Nick DeVino, the nose guard again, number 24 on the tackle.
Been doing a nice job. Here's the cheerleaders.
Here we go again. Dugan at the Wildcat.
This way you get a young man who's about 210 pounds, and he's going to go. Look at the way. Look, he threw a block. And he's going. Touchdown.
No, they're ruling him. They're ruling him just short.
It looks like he's throwing a block, and then he goes on.
But you also, if you notice, John, you also had the offensive line. Pushing the pile inside.
Absolutely.
The one, third down.
But here you got.
He was hit at the line of scrimmage. He just kept going, like you mentioned. Not only does he bring that speed factor we saw on the big run, he brings the power factor.
And he wants to throw a block for himself.
Yep.
Well, I think he's getting the ball again.
Now give it to Robbie Karsich that time. And
look at him. Touchdown.
That time they give the ball to Robbie Karsich on the jet sweep, and it looked like he was going to be tackled for no gain, but he just has that ability to make that subtle cut, and he got in.
I love that jet sweep. I love the sound. But you're right.
Cheerleaders, now they're going 19-0 there. They're a little excited now.
So now Dugan has to kick the extra point now. Look how easy.
And it's good. That time it looked like the snap got back a little bit harder and he was able to kick it, but it's been a perfect first half for Westwood right now, up 20-0 and with 8:39 left. And this is what you want to do when you're that big, you're that high seed. You want to get out early. You want to set the tone. And right, so far, so good. And again, now we got him kicking off again. Yeah. So
and you can save players down the road.
Yeah. The odds are he's going to put it in the end zone again and make Hanover Park go 80 yards again.
Well, yeah.
Yeah.
All season long, he's kicked it in the end zone of the games we were at.
Yep. And even if he kicks it inside the five, normally you'll get the ball on inside the 20.
Yeah. They don't need any kickers from the soccer field.
Maybe
they got Dugan.
That might be kicker tryout for next year.
What a player. I'm going to have to start calling Mr. Dugan.
Yeah. There's another one.
Look at this.
It'll be on the goal line, but let's see if we can cover this.
That's.
Again, now you pin him so deep that he returns it to the 19-yard line. Great coverage that time. And it's very easy, John, to be complacent on that kickoff team when you expect him to kick it in the end zone. You say, hey, maybe I can jog or get down. That's unbelievable.
That's the first time I've seen him not go into the end zone in the games that we did.
Tell you what, if you're Hanover Park here, you've got to do something. You've got to pick up a couple of first downs because there's – the old saying is it's getting late early. Jet sweep that time. Dugan again. Look at Dugan. That's a loss of about five.
This young man does it on offense, does it on defense, blocks.
We talked about before the game, Westwood's defense, 27 points given up in eight games, and that's 3 points a game. You can win a lot of games doing
that. Yep. Oh, that's a good pass. Nice pass. Beautiful pass to number 11 that time.
That's our man, Mr. Chris Smith, the 6'5 wide receiver. That gets them out of the hole. Puts the ball on the Westwood 40, the Hanover Park 43 yard line.
I would throw it to him again. Look for him. 6'5" frame. Oh, double reverse.
Got him on a pass.
What a call. A double reverse.
Great pass. He was wide open, and that's the way it's been so far for Hanover Park. Wide open. Just threw it out of reach of Smith.
Yep.
And let's be honest, Westwood got away with it. The defense got away with that.
Oh, absolutely. That should have been 7 points.
Should have been seven.
I agree with you.
We got second and 10 for Hanover Park on the 43.
Nothing inside.
Nothing. They ran inside zone that time. Number 8. Our by Yanni again. Constantinides. And Usher.
The inside line that time did the job for Westwood. Usher. Oh.
Gets away.
Great. Throw and catch.
Yeah, it had pressure. Morello pressure got away with it, stepped up.
And to Laparnos. That was a beautiful throw.
That's about a 35-yard throw. That gives them ball first down on the 27-yard line.
That's what they needed.
They were so close with the sack there. He got away. He stepped up. Kept his, most importantly, he kept his head up.
Yep. Oh, that...
Yeah, it looked it like bounced. The, it bounced. They brought pressure off the short side that time. They brought number 11, Tom Busanich.
Right.
Second and 10 for Westwood, for Hanover Park.
Tell you, the Hanover quarterback can throw.
He can throw the ball.
Wide open on the side. Number 6 with the catch.
Yep.
Spinelli.
Spinelli, their running back. Not only does he run well, he, as you see, he can catch the ball out of the backfield. And at about a 6.5 yard gain,
good
it'll bring
hands
up a 3rd and 3.5 on the 20-yard line.
And the quarterback got plenty of time that time to throw. So the offensive line did the job against Westwood.
Yep. Looks like it'll be a timeout, Westwood.
Yeah, you got to slow down this approach. So a quick timeout. The band is playing. Are they getting ready for halftime? With the clarinets, I see some clarinets in there. I played a clarinet at one time. Back in the Middle Ages. Nice huddle right there. They got good size.
Yeah, they
do.
51, the right tackle's nice size, but obviously
11. 2. Yep.
That's a nice target, a 6'5 target.
Oh, my God.
As the Westwood defense coach, Amir, settling the defense down.
Yeah, because they're getting a lot of time.
Yeah.
Hanover Park is getting time to throw. The quarterback has got nice size, and he's hitting the receivers.
Yeah, he's a dual threat, in a, kind of like a Robbie Carsage way. He's a power runner, and he could throw it.
Yeah. Well, it's been a nice, exciting game. Heck. That was like a dance step.
Yeah, it
you
looked
know?
Like a quarterback power that time. And it looks like he's going to be about a yard short. And again, big play here. That's 55.
55 was the
Joe Morrow on the bottom of the pile. Fourth and one for Hanover Park.
Fourth down Hornets.
Oh, nice.
What?
He was initially stopped on the first surge, bounced it to his right, picked up a first down. That'll put it first and 10 on the 15th.
Busanich on the stop.
Yeah.
But that was a big first down for
Hanover.
Hanover Park.
Screen. looking
knocked down.
Yeah, looking to set up a middle screen.
The line.
I was trying to pick up who did that.
And Usher
looked like 72 Usher with the deflection.
72. Look at that.
Brian Carr, he'll talk to anybody. We know that.
You're right.
Second and 10 for Hanover Park here. This is a big part of the game for Hanover Park. They have to get points.
Definitely got it. Without point. And Westwood comes back and scores, it could be turn out the lights.
Jet sweep.
Oh,
pass.
Look at that pass.
Just out of his reach. That time the secondary was deep where it was supposed to be. And it's a big third and 10 here.
Amelia.
And I don't think the Hanover Park, John, if they don't convert this, I don't think they can settle for 3.
No,
here.
I think they have to get
7.
Absolutely. So Amelia threw that ball.
Let's see if they try to isolate number 11, Chris Smith, up on the top of the left-hand side, a fade route or something. Now they're going to roll the quarterback right.
To the trips.
And he throws it, and it's incomplete.
Amelia's look at the ref and says, hey, what happened?
Yeah, there go to Westwood Faithful again. The Hanover Park thought there should have been a pass interference. I didn't think there was enough for pass interference. And it's 4th down and 10.
People are going crazy.
They can't get together now. No way.
Referees are meeting here. Let's see.
They're chatting.
Oh, man.
He threw a flag. Now, who got the flag?
Pass interference, Westwood.
Westwood. That's a big penalty
That's a rarity. I mean, that you don't call a penalty and you throw it down. Normally, you pick up a flag.
Yeah.
But that's not an automatic first down. That's only a half the distance penalty.
Okay. Well, like you said before, they need some points.
A third and two for the Hornets.
Two down situation, I think.
Yeah, we're probably gonna go to the quarterback. They look to lining up at a pistol set. Let's see if it's gonna be number one off tackle. There it is. And he's met at the line of scrimmage again by number 55.
Yeah, 55 and six. 55 is Morrow.
And number six, our man, Dario. And here we go again, fourth and three.
Oh, my God.
Let's see if they roll this kid out to his right here.
I think they all need a little timeout. Look at the bird. Look at that bird, hey? He's mean. You're mean, really. I'm afraid of you. Even at my age, I'm afraid of you. Oh, no, though. Look at those teeth. How come you don't have teeth in the front? Oh, yeah? I think I'm being dude'd out here. Hey! He's a meanie. Can you believe that? He's coming back. All right, back to the football game.
Big play here, fourth and about three for Hanover Park. This could be, you know.
They got to get it.
Great job, great pressure that time by number 11. Tom Busenich was right in the kid's face.
And that was a good call by the coach. They just didn't complete it.
Big stop by that defense, and that defense has been big all year. And let's see now if Westwood can pick up a couple of first downs and get that field position.
And you
back.
Change the momentum, yeah. and you going to 27-0.
But even if they can pick up a couple of first downs, and even if they have to punt and at least get the field back.
Oh, look at this. Oh, look at it, cuties. Well, back to the football game here.
Look at this.
All right, we got twins to the left, two backs. A power sweep.
Dugan looks like he got maybe a yard on that play. Good defense. The strength of this Hanover Park defense, John, is their ability to run sideline to sideline. We've seen that. This be a second and nine for Westwood.
I agree. 4:42 to go in the second quarter. They need a couple of first down if you're rooting for Westwood. They're nice size up front.
Yeah, they are.
There's Dugan.
That's a great run.
Look
hold
at him.
The ball. Hold the ball. They're looking to strip that ball. You got to hold that ball, especially when you're in traffic. The whistle was blown, but you can see Hanover Park looking to strip that ball.
Number three was trying.
Yeah. That's about 7 yards. I don't know what their coach is doing. Got an unsportsmanlike penalty on their coach. Oh, a sideline warning. Not an unsportsmanlike. Oh, yeah. That's a sideline warning.
Yeah, this game has been too good to have penalties.
They gave him a first down.
So Larry LeFury missed a good football game.
Yeah.
He's probably partying in Texas.
He'd be enjoying this. Oh, there comes the sweep to Robbie. He'll get out of bounds. About a gain of another six or seven.
You know, when he runs, he doesn't. He speeds up. He slows down.
He sets up his blocks. Yeah. But they really can put you in a bind where, you know, you have Karsich can run the ball. You have Dugan. You have Lawton. You have a bunch of different targets that can, that you know.
Yep. Fans are getting into the game. Look at the way he runs nicely.
There's another perfect example, John. Nobody open. He just takes it around right side for about 15 yards.
Oh, you know, Larry would love this game.
There he is. Oh, there's Larry. He is. He's got his Texas hat on.
That's it. That's the hat. Look at the horse.
The horse.
Oh, he must be out in the wilderness.
Larry, Larry had to, I believe, attend a wedding in Texas. And,
look at, I think the horse is biting him.
Oh my God!
Look at this. We lost control with that. Look at Larry, and he wasn't supposed to be here. What is he doing here?
Look at Dugan set that block up. Picked up about seven. And, you know, Westwood might now, at this point, with this field position, now they're looking to aggressively score another touchdown.
Well, that would be perfect for them.
I don't think Westwood's in any hurry right now, but
no, they want to make sure it scores some points and then take a break at halftime.
Oh, there he goes again. Oh, good job defensively by Hanover Park. Robbie Karsich picks up about two.
Yeah, that's one where the quarterback gets hit pretty good up the middle.
There's our man, Mr. Lopez, the middle linebacker, the sophomore. They're leading tackler.
Right,
they're leading tackler. Third down and about one.
He's a junior,
Westwood.
Right? Yeah. Is he a junior?
Sophomore.
Sophomore.
Dugan. Oh, stopped at the line of scrimmage. He falls forward, though, for the first down. He always has that forward lean, though.
Yep.
That's a first down for Westwood.
Because he was going the wrong way, then he switched.
Yep.
And got the 2 yards and a first down.
Don't be surprised if we see if Westwood at this point takes a shot off play action, tries to take a shot down the field.
Been an easy score to keep, you know.
Yeah. Let's see if they go play action here, John, to take a shot.
You got 1:28 to go.
Yep.
I think they got a couple of timeouts too.
I think they have one.
One.
Play action. Screen to Dugan.
Still going.
I think he's got another first down.
First down.
Stops. If he wasn't tackled out of bounds, the clock will stop till it was set. He was not tackled out of bounds, so now we got a minute and six and counting. Plenty of time, though. Plenty of time for Westwood.
Gain of about 8 yards.
Yeah, that time he caught it.
To Busanich, number 11.
They have one timeout, I think.
So 46 and running.
Second and three, Conno, turn the horn at 35.
We got a little trips to the left. He's looking. Oh, he's got room. He's going to run. He's got to go out of bounds.
And he gets out of bounds at about
and the first down, months. Right?
It looks to be close, maybe just a little bit short. But there's a smart quarterback knowing he had to get out of bounds.
Yep.
And not only, they don't need to score a touchdown. They have Dugan who can kick a field goal here too, which is another big weapon.
Oh, that would make three touchdowns, 23 points.
Yeah.
First down, Cardinals.
They do give him a first down. So first down and 10 for Westwood on the 32. And I'll tell you what, the Hanover Park defense has been out a lot.
Yep.
In the first half.
They got looks like a 3-4 right now.
That's the hole. It runs out of bounds that time at about the 34-yard line.
Stop the clock.
They lost 2 yards. Looks like they lost about a yard on the play.
Loss of one.
Second 11 with 23 seconds left.
Well, you get a couple of hits or get the ball up close and kick a field goal.
Well, you do have the timeout to set up the field goal too, so.
Yeah. Yeah, that would be the key, going up to 23 touchdowns.
Right now it would be a 50-yarder, so that probably is out of his range.
That's out of his range.
You probably want to pick up another 15 yards. Okay, incomplete.
Yeah.
And bring a third and 11 here.
He was going to Carrizana.
Yeah, that's a tough throw to make.
Yeah, because you don't want to overthrow and.
Yeah. Got to get your shoulders.
You can't get an interception out of it.
But you know what? They took over on inside the 10-yard line. They're on the 33. So.
Yeah.
Yeah, you know.
Well, you got Trips to the right, Singleton to the left.
Mm-hmm.
And you got plenty of room to run. Great defense by, looks like, what, 55?
I think you might have, you got a penalty down here. Referees discussing the penalty.
Down.
And now a lineman downfield on that. They'll decline it. It'll bring up
penalty
a fourth down.
Good move by the head coach. Yep.
Probably get a shot where they'll just throw a Hail Mary into the end zone.
The
or you fake throw and give the ball to 44.
Wait a minute. If the penalty was declined.
Because you got 11.1 seconds.
Yeah.
Oh, look at. That could be Larry.
I think the Westwood coaches want to know why the ball was moved back if the penalty was declined.
Yeah. Well, he's getting clarification, hopefully.
Yeah. Yeah, I think. This is Colby Lawton.
Yeah, I think that's going to be. Well, points. No, there it is. It's your clock.
And that's going to end the first half.
So it's 20-0 in the first half.
Yes, they tuned for halftime. I think we got the Westwood band, we got the cheerleaders, and we'll come back to recap it.
And we can relax and have a nice little relaxation. No more laughing. We'll be back.
Okay, so today was a very special day because John Francola up there celebrating his 80th birthday.
Ladies and gentlemen,
1942. Is that right?
Please welcome the 2022,
so before the game, we had a little celebration
Westwood
for our John.
Marching band.
Happy birthday to you. Happy birthday, dear John. Happy birthday to you.
Oh, no, not that. Is that going to be on today?
Wait a minute. Awesome.
We got to put that on.
So,
you know that.
We're going to have a special medal for
Mardi
you.
Gras. Yeah, it's your Mardi Gras.
It's your 80th birthday.
Oh, good.
8080.
That's
80th
tough.
Birthday.
That's tough. Oh, Dan Danny.
Okay, you have to cut the cannoli cake.
Oh, cannoli. I'm not good at this stuff, cutting.
Well, just take one slice and I'll do
how about this way? I'll go straight?
Yeah, yeah, yeah. Just half. Yeah. Just half. And I'll do the rest.
Johnny.
Yo, up there, John.
John, you need help cutting the cake or what?
Ho finito. Ho fatto.
I have to say that,
what's that?
We couldn't put 80 candles on it because we burned the place down.
I know
but
that.
Bobby is here, so yes, he we have a fireman here.
80.
Yeah, if we want to get a fire, Bobby can put it out.
Smoke. Look at that cut. That cut isn't
that's
bad.
Beautiful.
That's not bad.
That's beautiful.
Look at this. It should slide right out.
Straight.
I guess not.
Okay, good.
It's very dense.
John, you get half of that cake, you know?
Yeah.
Since you're 80.
No.
John, hold up your little character there.
Oh, yeah. You have to cut your friend.
Oh, the bobblehead. Yeah. That's
wild.
Yeah, it's good.
See what? I wanted to show the hair. Put it up there. Does it fit?
Yeah. Okay, John, go ahead.
You got it.
All right. Don't show this to my wife.
We're posting that everywhere.
Oh, my God.
Thank you.
Ladies and gentlemen, your 2022-2023 Westwood Marching Band and Color Guard. Ladies and gentlemen, please help me welcome your 2022-23 Westwood Cardinal Shoe Team.
Just quickly, as they're ready to kick off, it's very quick. In the first quarter, we had the Dugan show. 76-yard run, touchdown, then he kicked the extra point, made it 7-0. Then we had a 1-yard run for Dugan, making 13-0, a mixed field goal. You had a recovered fumble by Gabriotti, and then a 3-yard TD Carthage on a jet sweep, extra point, good, 20-0. And we're ready to play football for the second half. Look at that.
I tell you what, they got the grill going at the snack bar. Big, a lot of people eating tonight.
Oh, my God. Look at that.
Got it all. And it's funny, you talked about Dugan. Let's not forget his kicking in the first half. There's a perfect example of it there. He kicks it inside the five, and they cover it, and they got the ball on the 17-yard line.
That's another way of doing the game and winning games.
Bad snap, fumbled snap, and Westwood's all over it.
Number 55, was it?
Number 8.
Off by Luke Biello.
Oh, Constantinides.
Morrow also went at. And Biello, I mean, they're swarming right now, this defense.
Well, you know, it's time to put the game, if you can, put the game on ice.
Oh! Talk that about reading that screen.
Six. Number six on the play.
It's our man Dario Mathurin again.
Mathurin. Number five.
Dan Siros. He read Dan that screen Siros. Beautifully.
Oh, my God, yeah.
Third down and about 17. See if they bring pressure here, Westwood.
Yeah, it looks yes. that way. Oh.
Great job. Great job by the defense there. They complete a short pass for about 4 yards.
Yeah, you had number 34, Gabriardi, in there. Number 11.
Yeah, that was to number 11. Yeah, that was to their big receiver, Chris Smith. But again, look at the defense. They get out a three and out to start the third quarter. They should get great field position.
Well, you know, at halftime, you can make some adjustments. As always.
I'll tell you what, since that first drive of the first quarter, the defense has been lights out.
Absolutely. Well, I thought it was almost blocked. Yeah.
Caught on about the 41-yard line. Fair caught by number 9.
Joe Klein.
For the Cardinals. How to put the ball on you. How'd you like to have your first possession of a half on the opponent's 41-yard line to start?
That's not bad. That's not shabby. I would write that and pay whatever I needed to have it that way.
You know, you mentioned in the second quarter that the Westwood O-line is starting to gain control of this line.
In the beginning, they're not having problems, but I don't think they were ready to play.
Let's see if they start leaning on that big offensive line.
It everything starts with the offensive line. You know that,
yep.
right? Yep. The offensive line doesn't do a job. You don't win any game.
There's Robbie Karsich.
Yeah, they've been doing a great job on Karsich, yeah. I think.
It's about three. He hasn't hurt them between the tackles. He's actually hurt them on the perimeter with his scramble ability. But that, you know, three on first down, bring up a second and seven on the 37.
Only a junior. Nice future for that young man.
Yes, it is.
And he's got great speed. Throws the ball well. Oh, a little power, right? Huh?
They're going to run a sweep here. Look how we made people miss. So you had people that had a shot on him at the line of scrimmage. He picks up five, because that's up a third and two.
But if you're on the defense, you know 44, you know 44 is going to get the ball. You want to sort of play him, right?
Yeah, we have some out-of-town scores. We got Kinnelon over Park Ridge in the third quarter. That's a little bit of an upset. Kinnelon's the eighth seed. Fairleigh Regionals up over North Arlington, 30-8. Wardwick-Midland Parks up over Creskill, 9-7. And Mountain Lakes, 21-3 over Booton. Woodridge is up 22-8 over Shabazz.
Look at Karsich.
Karsich keeps. Goes out of bounds.
Looks like he had a running blocker final. For him.
Rutherford was a big over Mawa. They won 42-14. Madison is up 7-0 over Jefferson. The winner of this game will get the winner of that game next week. And next week will be the semifinals. And then the following week will be the sectional final. If Westwood holds on to the lead, they will be home next week.
It will be here, yes. And then the third game, if they win that one, we'll have to get.
Might be at Rutherford.
But we'll have to go to the state and get permission. Look at the man.
Dugan,
we almost lost the ball.
Yeah, Dugan off the left side, though, for another eight.
8 yards.
Maybe nine. 76. They're going to give him nine.
Number 50, Justin Singer.
Yeah, the ball was a little loose as he was going.
Yeah, second and one.
Bring up a second and one for the Cardinals.
He's a heck of a player. Yeah, Rutherford, that would be a good game.
They scrimmage each other. Yeah. There's Duke getting up the middle on an inside zone for another six. It looks like they're starting to wear him down a little bit up front.
And that's what you got to do here. You know, you well, obviously you want to get to 35, but you want to score and keep them from scoring. 69 looks like nice size player right there.
Yeah, Braden Roberts. He's a junior, too.
My God, yeah, good time young man.
We have the two big tackles, 76 and him.
They open up some big holes.
Robbie Carson.
Look at
him set it up.
And he doesn't get hit.
See him ladder that run in, out, in, and then smart enough not to take the hit.
I tell you what, I could teach him some moves in dancing. Oh, the slop, he'd be excellent with the slop. Yeah, but we got to tell people when we talk about the slop, it's a dance, you know?
Picked up 8 yards on that run. And, you know, again, when you're picking up 7, 8, 9 yards on first down.
And he doesn't, he switches gears. Yeah. You know, he waits for the block, and he protects the ball, obviously. And only a junior.
Let's see if they go to Dugan off the right side here behind the bunch formation. No, jet sweep, tucking inside, bounce outside. That's Lawton.
That's Lawton.
Looks like Lawton, he will have enough for a first down.
And now he's back, Lawton. Gives him another weapon.
Oh, they're going to call it just short, John. They're going to call it just short. Bring up third and about a half a yard.
So
but
what
it's
do
two
call?
Down. It's
you
two
call
down 44? Territory.
44. Put a big sign. 4-4. What an athlete. And with speed, you know. I think he's like, got to be over 200.
About 185, 190.
Yeah, but solid.
Empty formation. Wildcat, and here goes Dugan. Again, you know. He makes something out of nothing. He looked like he was bottled up in the line of scrimmage, and he's got great forward lean.
Get a block, and then he goes off his own block for another 2 yards.
Picks up about four or five yards. It'll be first and goal on the 2 yard line.
Looks like
3 yard line. And not only are you looking to put another touchdown, but you're milking the clock. You're already down under 6 minutes in the third quarter.
And that's good. Keep everybody healthy. Oh, look at this. We get a shoot.
Maybe we'll get a toss. Maybe we'll get toss here.
Look at this. 10 men blocking for
He walks in. Dugan touchdown. Again.
10 men in front of him.
Follows his blockers into the end zone for his third touchdown of the night. Cardinals 26.
That was a 10 blockers for lined up. That was nice. Look, got to get the shield. He's got to start cheering, right?
Here they go. Looking for the extra point from Mr. Dugan. And the kick is up. And it's good.
And the extra point is good. Cardinals 27, Hornets 0.
It's just been a very, very workmanlike, very methodical
drive
game so far for Westwood.
In the beginning, there was a little bit of getting ready to play, I thought. And then once they started, and I thought Hanover Park had a good beginning part of the game.
They did.
They were ready to play, you know.
Well, we knew they were going to be.
They're good. They're a good team.
Good football team. I think they're running into just a better football team tonight. And again, Dugan, here he comes out to kick. So it looks like he'll pin him deep again.
Yeah.
Very tough for an offense in high school to go a long distance, 80, 75, 80 yards, without committing a penalty, a fumble, you know.
That's true.
Very tough. 27-0, 5:22 left in the third quarter. It's been all Westwood.
Except for the beginning. I thought the beginning, Hanover Park had a nice game plan. They were driving, and then they were playing great defense. And all of a sudden, Westwood started doing, and Dugan, number 44.
He's going to sleep. My MVP. He's going to sleep tomorrow, I can tell you that. Line drive.
Oh, look at this. He did not kick it. He get a little squib.
A little squib.
He said the heck with it, not to kick it all away.
Again, though, great coverage that time. They get it out to the 26-yard line, so they're pinned again.
How many pounds do you think he loses in playing that game?
Probably a couple.
He's constantly moving. He's constantly playing. Oh, 45 degrees. 45. Oh, my God.
45 degrees.
Oh. You know, those old bones get cold.
They run toss out of this formation. There it
is.
Oh,
this is a pitch.
Yeah. Great job by the defense again. 11-9 that time. We have Tom Busanich
and Joe Klein. Klein.
That was one of the tendencies that you saw on film. When I watched film, I watched three of their game films. When they ran that tight bunch and they offset the running back to the bunch, it was toss. There it was.
Oh, good.
Trying to go with a post. They got him deep. And incomplete. Great. I tell you what, this kid throws a nice ball. He really does.
No, he's an excellent quarterback.
Quarterback throws a nice ball. Good coverage that time.
Nice wheels.
He does throw a nice deep ball, John.
Yeah. Impressed with the quarterback.
There's the weather, 45 degrees.
Dropping to 41.
Yeah.
In Italian, it's a 45.
There's coach talking to number 15, Jordan Yopis.
Yeah,
and
he
here's got him run a run.
Dugan
again.
Dugan
again
be.
With the pressure.
Let's see what they're going to do.
Fourth and nine. Wow, I like to be in Monte Carlo right now.
Yeah, because I don't have money, but I go to Salzburg. 56, nah, you're right. Go to Rijeka. Yeah. That's where almost where I was born, in Croatia.
Yeah. Fourth and nine, they're going to have to punt again, and Westwood, there's Dugan, he's finally getting the playoff.
Oh, my God. He's got to lose 4 or 5 pounds every game. What's happening?
Joe Klein.
got a penalty on Hanover Park. Again, intentional grounding.
Loss it down.
And take a look. They'll be punting out of their end zone. Look where Westwood will get field position again.
And we may be hearing Dugan.
And if Westwood would be able to score and get to 34, that the mercy clock would run.
All right.
See if they get it. See if they go after this, trying to block it. Now I think they're safety. Oh, forced. Again. I mean, it's a good punt. It's a 30-yard punt, but they'll take over on the 39-yard line.
And after the punt, Westwood will take over inside the Hornets' 40.
That's giving great field position to Westwood.
In the other section, North 2, Group 2, the number one seed, Caldwell's up 41-0.
Everything is advertised.
Ramsey is up over Bernards, 21-14. Glen Rock defeats Richfield Park, 13-7. And Newton, who's another very
good team.
Powerful team, is up 28-0 over Beckton.
All right. The cheerleaders are cheering. They did a nice job. They did a nice job at halftime. Very athletic. As we were having cookies. That's right, the touchdown club with cookies.
Look at this. Look at the crease. That's Kobe Lawton for 11.
Glad to see him back.
Number 69, Braden Roberts.
That time, you notice 69 was out there pulling the junior tackle, 6'3", 300 pounds. So they're working. And they're working him in there.
He'll play in that next level.
Another year in the weight room.
That's what you got to do with that. Make those 270 or whatever, 300 pounds.
Yeah.
Muscle. Build the speed and endurance.
Oh, counter with nice the quarterback.
Ooh, look at this. Whoop.
Look at this kid. Look at the escape. Great job by their defense forcing him to the sideline. But he makes a negative play into a 1 or 2 yard gain.
Spinelli did a nice job. Number six.
He's very, very good player on both sides of the ball.
I agree with you.
You saw his speed. There he is.
There he is, number six.
Now let's remember. 11,
look how big 11 is.
Yeah, 11
is.
He's 6'4", 6'5". Let's remember, this team last year went to the sectional final. So, you know, these seniors have had quite a run for Hanover Park.
Yep. Yeah, speaking with the head coach, he's a super nice guy. We did a great, great time.
So yeah, that time.
It's
number eight.
Konstantinides.
Yanni. All he does is, you know, he's the third back they put in there. All he does is pick up 6 yards.
Well, you know, at this point, if you're playing defense, you're down 27, and you get more and more run at you. He said, we need some points. Very clean game as far as penalties.
Yeah, it really has. I think Westwood has committed too. There's Dugan. I'm sorry. There's the quarterback. Carson's keeping. He'll be short. He'll be about a fourth and a long one, short two here. They've done a nice job, as you mentioned before, John, on the run on Carson inside the tackles.
Well, you got the big linemen too. And they execute, you know, and open up. And you just got to give him a little bit of room. Yeah. And then he's got speed and quickness.
But there, Hanover Park's defense for the next 2 years is going to be anchored by these outstanding linebackers. We mentioned they're all sophomores.
Oh, he's got a great future.
There's Mr. Dugan again. He gets about 8 or 9 yards for first down. Clock's running.
You know, Dave Fulton does a nice job, and I thank him. We had a problem with the computer, and we worked on it. And then they had security, and then finally says, the next day he said, John, I took you off the security. You'll be able to have it.
No, he's
and I thank you.
Very, very helpful with obviously helping us and you prepare for this game with all his stats, his rosters. We really want to thank them.
Oh, great job, really. And I appreciate it. Good luck to you. Number two. You know that, Lawton. Welcome back, Lawton.
You know, it's a tough thing to defend one player, but could you imagine having to defend Dugan, having to defend Carsage, having to defend Lawton? That, you know, you have to give something up as a defense. Yep. First and goal on the three, it looks like.
Ball is going to be given. Even one take himself or give it to two.
It's Lawton off the left side. He's pushing close up to the goal line. He's at about the one or the two.
All right. Oh,
oh, the bulldog.
What a nice dog. I like that dog. Boy, I tell you, look at the clothes he's got on. That nice.
He's warmer than we are.
Oh, my goodness. Look at him. He's just sitting there with three ladies there. What the heck? What do we got? We got all guys here. Look at it. Three ladies with the dog. And the plane with his ears. Look at that. I love it.
There's Lawton. He hit somebody at the three, and he ran him over. That's what you're talking about being 185, 190 pounds. He delivered the blow there and just ran the kid over into the end zone. We're at 33-0, and if they can convert the extra point, that'll give them the 34 needed for the running clock.
And Lawton, welcome back. And
yeah.
Power run, good blocking. Oh,
it's
my
happy
God,
bird.
Look at him.
Happy
he looks
bird.
Sad.
No, he's happy.
Well, look at the way he's walking. Look at him walk. I don't know what it is.
Extra point,
that's Dugan.
Dugan. It's good.
So, Dugan's extra point is good.
So with 44 seconds left in the third quarter, we've got Westwood 34, Hanover Park nothing.
Well, the clock will move now.
I heard the cheerleaders. They're starting to get into it a little bit. A lot of smiles on the faces of the cheerleaders when you're
absolutely
up 34-0.
They did a nice job at halftime. You know what? Cheerleaders are a big part of football.
Hey, they, you know, everybody knows that the football team's out there all summer in the heat and practicing, but, you know, you look over your shoulder, they're out there practicing just as much.
And they, I'll tell you, they're an intricate part of a football game.
The Dugan, another line drive. That'll hit the end zone, and that'll be another touchback.
Toe.
Another
Dugan to toe.
Another possession that'll start in on the 20-yard line. I'd like to have if we were able to do the stats, the average start yardage. You know, from Hanover Park's been starting way deep inside their 20-yard line. Westwood's been starting in midfield, so. You know, that's been a big difference.
You're right.
That might, you had a running clock. That might be the last play of the quarter. We'll see.
We got to make sure all the names.
As we come to the end of the third quarter, Cardinals 34, Hornets nothing.
There's Paul. Look
There's
at Paul.
Paul
looks like he doesn't look cold. He looks good though. He's got the one hand going, the right hand, right? Nice job, Paul. There's one.
You may collect your winnings.
There's
up here at the press box.
Lou's probably up there in the cold.
Yeah.
Let's see Lou.
Heck of
a Lou.
Does a great job. One of the best camera person in the state of New Jersey. And he's cold.
Yeah.
Yeah.
Tell you what, you
looks good.
Very fortunate that the crew you guys have for years, you've done an unbelievable job with the camera. It's
on.
A professional job.
You can see the shots.
Yeah. Another possession starting at the 20.
Yeah.
02-991.
Fake, oh my God, you see that? That's how you get, he faked the pass.
Another sack.
And then got hit. That hurt.
Luke Biello.
Biello.
On the sack.
Oh, but. Oh, yes.
John's 80th birthday medallion.
Look at this, look at the 80th. And you can tell I'm 80. This was enjoyable, by the way. Get Ricky. Oh, I'm sorry. I'm sorry. I missed him. There's Ricky. Ricky has been taking, and he's been making us laugh.
That's right.
And of course, you got Jimmy. And my wife loves me to say, Jimmy.
Abitable.
And
of course, Ida.
Ida Astuti, the best person on earth. And nice thank you for the birthday party. Mi piace tanto.
Oh. Third and
I was
third
being,
and 14.
I was being corralled by the wire. back in the game.
Throwing deep down, overthrown. Again, pressure by number six, Dario Mathurin, put pressure on the quarterback again. And I'll tell you what, though, John, Mike Borrello has stood in there and delivered the football under a lot of pressure, but it's fourth and 15. They're going to have to punt again. And, yeah, it is. Right now it's a running clock. And, again, look what Westwood is set to get the ball again.
I know. The short field comes up to scoring points. Yeah, I like to get the ball into the 40.
Every time. Okay, nice kick. Let's see, we're going to get a fair catch. He's going to let it go. Poison, and they'll touch it down.
Probably one of the further back.
Oh, there he is.
Oh, Brandon. What a cute dog. Oh, my goodness, she's cute.
He's got his varsity jacket on? Oh, no. No, no, no.
Nice jacket.
Scott,
sweater.
Look at him.
Look at that.
Look at her. Oh, beautiful.
Beautiful dog. Look at that. Look at that.
Should get her in the booth.
Boy, look at this.
Game.
She's having.
Get her and get her.
They want her
get
to
her
bark.
In the booth for the next game. First and
look
first
at that.
And 10 for. First
wait, here we go, back
Westwood.
In the
game. Oh.
This is number 21 for Westwood.
And it's
Sabatella.
Sabatella, he's coming back. As you remember, John, Sabatella came off a major knee injury last year.
Oh, you're right.
Tore his ACL. He's working his way back. He's healthy. And that's nice that he's been able to, the injury happened
yep.
9 months ago. So
sure.
To get him back is nice for the senior.
And this is what you want to do in this game. You
yeah.
want everybody to get in there.
Yep. And
get them ready for next week.
We have a holding penalty on Westwood. But for Westwood, give him some work at tailback.
First and 15.
They had a holding penalty.
Yeah. Putting up a first and about 16 for Westwood.
This is something they haven't had all day.
Good run. Nice run.
21.
Yeah,
Sabatella.
Sabatella again.
But it looks like the quarterback wanted the ball.
You know, I was talking to Coach Hart at practice yesterday about Sabatella, and he said, Jimmy, he's just, you could just see him getting into shape. He's starting to regain what he had.
All right.
So he's another kid in the next couple of weeks. You could add him to the weapons that Westwood has.
You know, hey, 34-0.
Yeah.
So they only have given how many points for the season?
They were giving up 13 points a game.
But I'm saying Westwood's only
given up 27. Here goes Lawton. He cuts it up. For a gain of about two.
And this is good to give Lawton the ball.
Yeah, get him some work.
Get him some work, because he's another one of those people that can really help you
gonna get
in
a,
big games.
Yeah, going to get a third and five.
You can see that he was a little bit
now, I think Westwood. I think Westwood has only punted once in the game.
That's true.
The first possession. There's the Westwood sideline. They're starting to mix in some of the twos. Getting some of those younger kids experience. Yeah, you can see you getting colder.
The temperature's gone, getting down.
The breath of the D lineman.
Did you see that? The middle guy switched legs.
There he is again. Off the left side, he picks up about, Sabatella picks up about three. That'll bring up a fourth and two. Let's see if Westwood goes. Now they're going to send the punting unit out.
Yeah.
And hope to.
This is where you work. You work on
yeah,
the punting.
Yeah, work on the punt uniting and hopefully pin them down again. But do we know those guys? There he is talking to someone again, Brian Carr. And yeah. And, Bobby Baines, he's looking. Look at him looking at scores. He's trying to get updates of scores.
They love to go football games.
Got it.
Hey, there's not. Hey.
Good guys.
Yeah. Yes.
Well, it looks like I think it's, look at this, they're going to pin him inside the 8-yard line, 5-yard line. And, John, it looks, obviously, I think it's safe to say Westwood's going to win this game. They will host next Friday night either Madison or Jefferson.
All right, we're going to have to do a little
find out who won that game, yeah.
991.
It looks like in both North 1 and North 2, both in Rutherford, the number one seed, and Westwood will advance. And in the other bracket, the Newton, the 2 seed, and number one Caldwell will advance. So the four power teams are moving on.
I'm worried about Caldwell. Look at this. That's some group. Where do you think they're going? I don't know.
Another no gain on a run. 5 minutes and counting. You know, the running clock is really a nice thing when you get a score that's out of hand.
There's no way that someone can come back. So to me, it's the way to go. You protect the plays, because you know yourself, when you're not playing full out, that's when you get hurt.
Right.
In games. This is a great throw.
Oh, that's a
great
catch. Great
catch. We got to talk about number 11. Chris Smith. That was a heck of a catch.
Yeah.
Good size for
really,
Smith.
Really talented receiver. And again, great throw on the run.
Nice
by
hands.
Mike Barella.
That's got to be one of the longest plays of the day for them.
Yeah, they had two long plays. You remember the first drive, they completed a 30-yard. I think they've had three 30-yard pass plays. Yeah.
Yeah, the first quarter, they were playing extremely well.
They're going to run the wheel here. They're going to run the wheel. Coverage by seven. Aiden Carrizana.
People, I don't know. They're all cold, though. God, they're cold. They're not smiling. I would look. You got 335. I hear a week singing goodbye. So 3:15 and running.
Yep.
Tackle by Sabatella and Gordon. Bring up 3rd and 8 for the Hornets.
There go Larry, there goes Bobby and Brian Carr. They're heading out. Turn out the lights. I'll tell you what.
See what I'm doing?
Yeah, they've been able to pressure him all night long. He's been running for his life back there. As the voice of Westwood.
I was just giving thumbs up to number 44, Jack Dugan's mother, giving a thumbs up. What a great job his son did.
Great job. Always sets us up with coffee and everything.
They do a great job for us. You know, I feel like $1 million with them.
We got a 4th down and 8 here. They're bringing pressure. Oh boy. And he's got to throw it under duress. And there she is.
There she is. This dude did a nice job.
Yep.
Oh, the cookies, the coffee. She does a great job every week. And we'll see you next week.
We'll be right back here in Washington Township.
And hopefully Westwood will continue its winning ways.
So that'll pretty much end it here. Westwood could take a knee, end the game. Want to recap?
We'll just give them. At halftime, of course, was 20-0, and we started the third quarter with a 3-yard touchdown by Dugan. Extra point was good, made it 27. Then you had a 2-yard touchdown by Lawton. Welcome back, Lawton. Moved the game to 33, extra point by Dugan, making 34. At which point now the game is running out. Less Well, less than a minute.
As Coach Hard with his victory in his first round of the playoffs.
We'll have to, if we can, we may be able to get him or... All right, okay.
We'll catch him. We'll catch him before the game next week.
Before next week.
Yeah.
Did a great job. Coaching staff and the coach did a great job. The kid did a great job.
And I think that'll be the last snap. They won't need to take another snap. And Westwood.
Another shutout.
They'll take that 3 points a game and they'll lower that if that's possible. They advance to the semifinals next week here. And
WCTV will be here.
Yep, John will be here with Larry. Larry will be back, and I want to coach you shaking hands. A lot of respect. Want to thank you guys for allowing me to fill in.
Oh,
Larry.
You did a great job. Hey, listen, it was great here. We had a lot of laughs. Thank you, and of course we thank Ida and all of you for a little birthday party.
Yep.
Good thing I didn't bring wine, though. My wife said, don't do it. She was right. Good night, everybody.
Good night, everybody.
We'll see you next week. Same time, same station in Washington Township.